How's it going, guys? And welcome back to another week, and of course, another Grandmaster guide. This week, we're going through Corrupted, which is probably the most unforgiving of all the Grandmasters this season, because quite frankly, it's hard. It's actually the hardest Grandmaster in rotation this season. And with that, I'm going to do my best to give everybody a competent guide so that this way they can get through it, get their loot, and never have to touch it again. So, let's get started. As soon as you load in, the party gets started immediately with an overload champion directly in front of you. They waste no time with this Grandmaster giving you champions, because in this area alone, there's three of them. There's going to be this overload captain, chieftain, whatever they're called, and two overloads in the back. What you're going to do for this area first, though, take care of the snipers on the left-hand side, as they will sneak up on you and absolutely murder you. Luckily for us, we had a team member who likes to play fairly aggressive, and he went ahead and got rid of most of the Void Shield acolytes for us. Now, with this area, there's two things you can do. What you're going to see us do, and then the other way, which is, clear out most of the adds and go to the right-hand side up behind the mountain to fight the boss. But what we did is we just went head-on and tackled the two overloads and the boss so that this way we got through it very quickly and moved on to the next area, which is really nice because they removed the adds from the area in front of the elevator, which is nice. So take out these two champions that you're going to see here and the boss, and then move on to the elevator room. Now, like I said previously, there are no adds in this area before the elevator room, but if you're still here and you are interested in this content, please like, comment, and please consider subscribing for future videos and whatnot. And with that, let's move on into the elevator room. Now, the elevator room can be a touch tricky. There are a few scions here that you're gonna have to deal with. They're just little red bars. Don't let them multiply and you'll be okay. What you're gonna do is you're gonna start passing these relics between you and your other two allies. Now, they have a timer of 30 seconds. You can only hold them for 30 seconds. You're gonna charge up three of them, and you're gonna wait for these big boys with the shields to spawn, like you see on screen, and you're gonna throw your artifacts at them. You're gonna have one left. He's gonna be like the big boss of this whole little area. Don't kill him just yet. Killing him activates the next stage of this encounter, which is very much so like this first part. You're gonna deal with all these little adds. Make sure he's the only one left. What you're gonna do is you're going to charge up more of these artifacts. You're gonna need at least two, maybe three more. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna rotate the opposite direction of this boss, have someone pick up the relics and start tossing them between you and your other allies. Even if that is yourself, that's what you're going to do. Once you have these relics charged, you're going to kill the boss. You're going to do very much so the same thing. You're going to wait for them to spawn, and then you're going to throw the balls at them. This is where you want to throw your supers. The supers we used were very good to keeping the enemies locked in one place so that when the relics did their thing and exploded, it also took out a vast majority of the red bar adds with them. Once you get past that wave, we can move on to the, I guess, pre-ogre room. Once those doors open up, you're going to be met with a bunch of hive and a shrieker and an unstoppable ogre. Deal with the unstoppable ogre, deal with the hive, and then the shrieker. Move forward. This area is really not very complex, so we're not going to go over it too much. Once you get past this first little section with the first shrieker, it's just more arc shielded knights, it's just more unstoppable ogres, and it is just more shriekers. Deal with them, be safe, use cover, and then we can actually move into the ogre boss room, which is a bit tricky. Once you climb these stairs, the ogre room encounter is going to start. What you're going to want to do first is find the unstoppable ogre and start picking away at him until you are teleported into the castaway realm. Once you get in there, it's going to be the same thing, except stand behind this pillar where you see us, and if you keep watching, you'll notice that the two unstoppable champions are running to that staircase because they are written, like their code is written to go up those stairs to deal with people going up there. We're not going up there like you would most likely see. We're sitting back here dealing with these champions. So you're going to kill the unstoppable ogre in this first room, and you're going to then get teleported back, and you are going to deal with the two unstoppable phalanxes that are still going to run to the stairs. Like, I'll show you the clip right here where we get teleported back in for the second time. I aim down sights with my scout rifle, and look at that. There's both the champions just making a run for those stairs. Kill all the champions in here, And then this is where it's kind of up to you. You can choose to get rid of the castaway ogre first, so that's why you're locked into the normal realm, or you can kill the normal ogre and get locked into the castaway realm. If you do not have an Invis Hunter on your team, I highly recommend that you try to stay in the normal realm, because the castaway realm has those shriekers. It's a pain, but it's completely up to you. Once you get rid of both ogres, we'll move on to the next area, which I don't even know what to call, but I'm going to show you how to do it anyways. Once you deal with the ogres and are brought to this area, like the gate in front of the ogre arena, you're going to deal with two unstoppable champions. Now, in this area, there are six champions to deal with. Let's deal with these two unstoppables first. You know, they're really easy to deal with. This room is really not that much of a problem, but the overloads at the end can sometimes get people, you know, tripped up, or even that little mini boss at the end can get people tripped up, and there's just a really easy way to deal with him. We'll go over that when we get there. Deal with these two unstoppable champions and make your way down the stairs. Now, in this footage, one of the overloads got a little frisky and he pushed up the stairs. Normally, he'll be in like either the back left or back right corner. I'm going to show you how to deal with him when we get down there, just like in case he doesn't, you know, do this again for whoever's watching this, whoever's using this guide. But there's going to be two more unstoppables down there in like that middle platform area. Same thing as before, just get rid of them. Unstoppables are probably the easiest champions to deal with. They're a joke. Get rid of them. And then we're going to look at, you know, how to deal with these overloads and that mini-boss that you can see just staring at us. Now, once you deal with those unstoppable champions, you can deal with these overloads. Now, there's one on the left, which we're dealing with now. Basically, what you want to do with these two overloads, luckily, you know, like I think you saw earlier, one of them pushed us, we didn't have to deal with them. You're going to focus on one of them, single him out, like this one's out of cover, kill him, get rid of him, have him go bye-bye. And then you're going to work on the other side. Whichever one is easier for you and your team to deal with, that is the one you're going to deal with first. Once both those champions are dealt with, this is how you deal with that mini boss. You just walk up and you'll walk right past him. You have no reason to kill him, waste your ammo, or waste lives. Just leave. Go into the next area. You have no reason whatsoever to fight this guy. Period. Just leave him alone. Move on to the next area. It is not worth the potential res wasting. Then you get to the big drop, and the easiest way to deal with this is just go one at a time. And honestly, what we did is we just had one person go down and pull us so that this way there'd be no potential dying. It's a lot safer. It's a lot easier. Just don't play this part stupid and you'll be okay. Now, once you get down here or you are pulled, whichever one, there's not a lot really here to explain. It's a lot of your standard just deal with adds, deal with champions, and move on. However, there's one thing I'm going to show you that's really, really good about this part. This overload that you just saw me shoot at, 9 times out of 10, he'll just walk off the map. So you don't really have to focus much energy on him. Shoot him a couple times, get his attention, and he will walk off the map like you just saw. Continue through here, and we will get to the boss arena, which is probably the most irritating and complex part of this entire strike. Once you get into the boss arena, you're going to sit on this platform to deal with pretty much everything that's going to come at you. Sadia is going to move to the right side, sit behind this crystal, wait for the adds to jump across. Deal with all the adds in front of you. Throw supers, whatever you have to deal, whatever you have, deal with these adds first, as they'll kill you. If you're not careful, they will get rid of you. There's a bunch of scions that'll duplicate themselves, and there's a bunch of solar shielded knights that you're going to have to deal with. Once the adds have been dealt with, one of your teammates can go to the left-hand side and pick up one of those relics like we saw from the elevator room. Go over, pick it up, bring it back, pass it back and forth, and get ready to throw it at Sadia. Now, when this happens, this is a very crucial moment where you're going to decide whether you're going to do one of two things. You can either, one, do this normally, or two, try to quick burn her. Now, the quick burn method is once you pop her shield here, like you're about to see, you do not damage her at all, period. No damage. One point of damage, and it'll mess up the whole thing. What you're going to do is you're going to throw it, pop it, don't damage her, kill the adds, and you move to the back of the room where you can easily damage her. However, we didn't go with that approach because we figured it'd be some people just won't be able to do that. So we went for the long haul. So you're going to throw it, damage her, get her to move to the other side while you deal with all these adds in front of us. Again, supers, abilities, whatever you have, throw them out there. All the adds are going to be in that one little space. Once those adds have been dealt with, you're then going to go to the right-hand side, and you're going to grab another relic, and then you're going to run back, toss it back and forth, pop her shields, do damage. Now, this is a very important thing that got us wiped on one of these runs. Once she goes into that ascendant realm, the platform you are standing on turns into a no-turn back zone. One of the ones that will kill you, not the whole, oh, you're joining allies. This spot will kill you when she goes into the ascendant plane. So, as soon as she is ready to move, get out of this spot and move to the portal, where we're going to go over the next part of this encounter. Once you go through the portal into the ascendant plane, you're almost there. However, the part before you're actually done, to me, is arguably the hardest and most frustrating part, because you're so close, but it is so easy to wipe here and make it so you go back to orbit and restart however long it's taking you to do this. This took us almost the full 45 minutes. And I can only imagine, actually I can't imagine, because we wiped at this part 4 or 5 times in 1 week trying to get through this. So I'm going to show you the tips and tricks we did to make it easier. Now, before we get up to the donut ring encounter area, let's go over a little tips and tricks for this little jumping area. And that is, deal with the ads, jump up, and just move forward. There's an overload champion in the beginning and an unstoppable phalanx right at the end of this area. Deal with them, deal with the solar knights, try not to get blasted by Sadia because she will one-shot you here. Get through this and get to the area where you have the final boss encounter. Once you get up to the donut ring arena, you're gonna send someone up, and they're gonna trigger the ads to spawn. They're gonna come back here, and all you're gonna do is just pick off the ads little by little and just make it so that you don't have to deal with them when you get up there. What your future ally is gonna do is he's gonna get up there, get the ball, and hopefully they can come back to you. I think something happened here where miscommunication, but have them go up, get the ball, bring it back, and just deal with the ads. Now, when you are ready to actually damage her, you're all going to jump up into this ring because this area eventually turns into a no-turn-back zone, and it will kill you. It actually killed us because we were fed bad information from another video we were trying to watch to try to understand how to do this efficiently. Fed us very bad information. It was slightly outdated, and we died because of it. So, I'm telling you right now, when you get ready to damage her, jump up into the ring, hit her with the ball, and get her shield to come down. Damage her. Once her second shield comes up, this is very important. There are 2 captains that are going to spawn with her. They take the absolute utmost priority. They will absolutely 100% one-shot you and kill you. It happened to us a few times. You're going to want to avoid her blasts, and you're going to hit her. And then once you have her second shield pop, damage her. More ads will spawn. Ignore them. Just focus on Sadia. And once you have done that, you can finally beat Corrupted and never have to set foot into this awful strike ever again. This is my least favorite Grandmaster strike above literally anything else. I used to have Glassway at the top of the list for the worst. No, it's this. Something about this strike I just do not like. I just don't like it. So that, let's just go over the loadouts really quickly and check out my new little layout I tried and let me know what you think about it. As far as loadouts are concerned, I ran Silence and Squall and Star Eater Scales. I ran Star Eaters not for the damage bonus you get from collecting orbs after getting full super, but to be able to get my super back faster. For weapons, I ran Aegir Scepter to feed back into my stasis stuff, Staccato 46, to deal with the solar shields and unstoppable champions, and Storm Chaser, as this is Arc Burn, and it's, you know, it's probably one of the best linear fusions we have in our disposal. For some mods, you know, for my build, I ran Elemental Shards, Well of Tenacity, Font of Wisdom, Taking Charge, and High Energy Fire, all to feed back into or get fed to by my Stasis subclass and my Stasis Shards. My second teammate ran Quiver and Omnioculus, as those are fantastic choices for a Void Hunter, as well as Osteostriga, Staccato 46, and Storm Chaser. Osteostriga was really good dealing with those overload champions. Definitely highly recommend it. And for mods for his build, he ran Melee Wellmaker, Reaping Wellmaker, Well of Utility, Bountiful Wells, and Reactive Pulse. This is because he would run up, Shadow Dive on things, pop the shields, kill them, spawn with Melee Wellmaker, get his dodge back with utility, dodge for reaping, bountiful wells, and then, you know, reactive pulse because he was up close and personal. It all fell in quite well and worked very well, and my final teammate ran Winter's Wrath with Osmiomancy Gloves. For weapons, Wither Horde, Vouchsafe, and Storm Chaser. All very, very good, very valuable options, as well as Elemental Shards, Well of Tenacity, Elemental Time Dilation, Font of Wisdom, and we all ran Revitalizing Blast, as it is by far one of the best mods I have ever played with, just watching champions explode constantly. With that, though, that is finally the end of this video. Now, I hope you can use this and get through this Nightfall, as this is probably one of the most challenging Nightfalls in rotation. So, use it, take this and make your own strategies if you need to, but get it done, because this one is really hard. Next week, we'll be at it with Arms Dealer, which I have a really fun build to go over, and it's one of my favorites that I've played with so far. So, I'll see you all next week.